Hello and welcome to NCRT's Live Interaction. This is Simran Singh. You are watching us through PM Evidya. Or you can also connect with us through our YouTube channel, that is NCERT Official. In case of doubts, queries, anything you feel like talking about related to our topics, related to our experts or the feedback, feel free to contact us on our toll-free number, that is 8800440559. So as today in the session, we'll be discussing about class 12th. Our official mail ID where you can write to us for class 12th is dth.class12@ciet.nic.in. As I already mentioned, we'll be discussing about class 12th sociology subject. And our topic of discussion for today will be the demographic structure of Indian society, chapter 2. And to have a discussion about this topic at length, we are in conversation with two experts. Let me introduce them to you. Our first expert is Mrs. Seema Banerjee. Hello, ma'am. Welcome.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Yeah. Mrs. Seema is PGD Sociology and currently serving at Lakshman Public School in New Delhi. Hello, ma'am. Welcome. We also have another expert joining in here, Mrs. Abha Seth. Hello, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
Abha ji is PGD Sociology and currently serving at DAV Public School, New Delhi. So, as I mentioned that we'll be discussing about the demographic structure of Indian society. So, let us commence our session with the basics of demography. Over to you, our experts.
Yes. Yeah. Good afternoon, everyone. And good afternoon, students. As you know, today our topic for discussion is the demographic structure of Indian society. And this is the second chapter of your NCERT's class 12 textbook, titled Indian Society. Now, before, you know, elaborating on the various terms and concepts, theories, demographic dividend, let's first understand the term demography. What is demography? Now, demography, it is the systematic study of the population. It studies the growth, size, composition, and the movement of the human population. And the term demography, it is a Greek term that has been derived from the two words, demos, people, and graphia, description of people. So demography, it studies the birth, migration, sex composition. Now let us understand why it is important as a subject, for as a, you know, social science subject, or the what is the relationship between demography and sociology. Now, if you see that there's a close connection between the, you know, the field of population studies, which focuses on the relationship between the demographic variable and the social system. Now, demographic processes, they include, you know, consist of fertility, mortality, and migration. And demographic structure includes age composition of the population, male, female, you know, composition, size of the population. So therefore, you know, demographic studies the trends and the processes which are related to the population. Now, depending upon these, when we talk about the demography, can be, there are two types of it. One is formal and the second one is social demography. Now, the formal demography, it is basically, you know, concerned with the quantitative measurement, analysis of the population, the mathematical study. Now, as you know, students, aap sabhi ko malum hai kya jo after every 10 years census is carried out, isn't it? So, the census, when we talk about, it involves a detailed, you know, process of collecting, compiling, analyzing, and evaluating the data which have been collected about the entire country's population. And then it is also disseminated to the masses for the information, which, you know, later on, Abha ma'am will be talking about the importance of the demographic data. Now, that is the formal demographic, that is the quantitative measurement. Now, the another type of demography is the social demography. which deals with the social, economic, and the political aspect of the population. Now, social demographers, you know, they believe that the social processes and social structure, like socialization, caste, class, you know, they regulate the demographic process. So all these processes, directly or indirectly, they affect the demographic variables. Okay, so now it's clear to all of you that what the term demography means. Now I will request Abha ma'am to elaborate on the importance of the demographic data.
Yes, children. Now, whatever data that is collected is of very important relevance to the sociologist. हमने जितना भी statistical data, जैसे ma'am ने बोला है formal demography, that means the statistical data that has been collected. Majorly, this is used for planning, and all that planning is to bring economic growth and welfare program. Economic growth means कि जहाँ पर, for instance, आपको industrial growth चाहिए, कहीं पर agricultural growth चाहिए, तो हर area को identify करना है कि how the areas are, you know, requiring certain improvements. What is the type of population residing there and how to tap that population. So, kaise skill development ke zariye, education ke zariye, usko aage badhana. How to utilize the human resource. And koi bhi condition jo desh ki hoti hai, usme sabse pehle jo uski population hai, usko consider karna zaruri hai, uski kya needs hai. So along with the economic growth, there are certain welfare measures. If we talk of, for instance, the need for schools in a village, if we talk of schools in a village, we need to understand कि उस village में किस age group के बच्चे हैं, कितने boys हैं, कितने girls हैं, और किस type की infrastructural facilities वहाँ पर जरूरी है. तो कोई भी जो हम बात कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे डेमोग्राफिक डेटा फॉर द प्लानिंग पर, दैट प्लानिंग इज टू बी डन इन ऑर्डर टू ब्रिंग वेलफेयर. सो द फर्स्ट स्टेप ऑफ दिस प्लानिंग इज बेसिकली टू आइडेंटिफाई द नीड. द सेकेंड स्टेप इज टू एस्टैब्लिश गोल्स दैट वी नीड टू अचीव दिस. एंड द थर्ड इज टू रिव्यू द प्रोग्रेस, to monitor the progress. एक बार कोई आपके कोई plan जब implement होता है, उसका सबसे बड़ा उसका result जो है वो ही बताता है कि वो plan effective था कि नहीं था. So it is with respect to the population there and the needs of the population, the needs of the citizens in that particular context, whether it is rural, whether it is urban, skill development. आप सोचिए, इवन फॉर हेल्थ पर्पसेस, फॉर वैक्सीनेशन दैट इज गोइंग ऑन, द ड्राइव दैट इज गोइंग, द ड्राइव फॉर क्लेनलीनेस, द काइंड ऑफ यू नो द जो हमारा स्वच्छता अभियान है इसमें टॉयलेट्स की कंस्ट्रक्शन के ऊपर था. तो एवरीवेयर द डेटा इज द डेमोग्राफिक डेटा, एवरीवेयर द पर्पस इज टू फाइंड आउट वेयर रिफॉर्म प्लानिंग इम्प्रूवमेंट इज रिक्वायर्ड. And therefore, there is a very close relationship, as we can see, between the demographic data and the its use for the sociological purpose and social improvement. So all our policies and planning are based on this demographic data. Now, apart from this, there are certain social phenomena. Ek concept aapne padha hai, aggregate statistics. कुछ ऐसा डेटा विच इज नॉट रिस्ट्रिक्टेड टू अ स्मॉल टेरिटरी और अ नेशन, इट कैन बी ऑन अ वेरी लार्ज स्केल. सो इट ऑल्सो शोज सर्टन ट्रेंड, उसमें स्विच रेसिज्म हो सकता है, even death rates to some extent is a social phenomenon. So the statistics, the data is a reflection. वो बता रही है कि सोसाइटी की क्या कंडीशन है, सोसाइटी को क्या चाहिए, लोगों के लिए कहाँ कैसे इम्प्रूवमेंट हो सकती है. सो दैट वे दिस इज द ट्रू रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन डेमोग्राफिक डेटा एंड द सोसाइटी एट लार्ज एंड इट्स चेंजेस दैट इट रिक्वायर्स ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. Now next, I will proceed to the demographic theories. Out of these, I'll be taking up the first one, the Malthusian theory of population growth. Now this is a theory which relates to important things. One is the power of the population, and the other is the power of the economy. So when we talk of power of the population, we are basically trying to understand power word to use kiya hai yahan Malthus ne. We are considering the strength of the population or how fast the population increases. Now this is his belief, this is what the theory is all about, that population grows at a much faster pace, bahut hi tezi se badh. And the power of the earth, so earth ki power hai, that he is talking about the means of human subsistence, that is anything related to agriculture and agricultural growth. Usme food hai, clothing hai, so anything that we get through agriculture is produced at a much lower speed pace. To unka ye kehna hai ke ek जो पॉपुलेशन है वो बढ़ रही है बहुत ही हाई स्पीड से, जिसे उन्होंने बोला है ज्योमेट्रिक प्रोग्रेशन, एंड द अदर इज थ्रू अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन. बोथ कॉन्सेप्ट्स ट्राइंग टू रिलेट द स्पीड और द इंटेंसिटी विद विच बोथ आर इंक्रीजिंग. सो द पावर ऑफ पॉपुलेशन इज एक्सट्रीमली high in this case, according to him. And this creates, he says, an imbalance. Obviously, when the population is high and the other facilities and subsistence provisions are low, there is bound to be poverty and starvation. Ab wo dono cheezon ka balance jo hai wo bigad gaya, to there is only one solution, which also he suggests. Otherwise, he says that we will be living in perpetual poverty. Lekin kuch solution wo suggest karte hain, and that is that the population has to be controlled. Ab population ko bhi control karne ke unhone do tarike bataye, ke balance to restore karna padega if there has to be eradication of poverty, starvation. So there is one check. There are two checks he's telling us about here in the book. One is the preventive check. As the word suggests, preventive means something which can be stopped through intentional methods, through volunteering, through methods that can be used by one's own judgment. So here, when he says preventive methods, he's talking about abstinence, late marriages, so that children are not born, means the population does not increase or it falls or it reduces to whatever extent it can. So prevent karna hai, that is one of the ways to control population, because that is the only way, he says, prosperity can come. Otherwise, there will be a perpetual state of poverty. The second method, jo inhone bataya hai, wo hai positive checks. Ab positive checks jo hain, wo kuch aise hain which are beyond human control. For example, we have famines, disease, and what your wars, of course, are there, and what we are experiencing now. Abhi hum kya experience kar rahe hain? the pandemic. So these are the kind of situations which restore the balance between the power of the population and the power of the government. But he is not very confident about this in the sense that he has just suggested these two ways in his theory. इसीलिए इनकी थ्योरी को काफी हद तक क्रिटिसाइज किया गया है वो इसीलिए क्योंकि जो क्रिटिसिज्म है वो आएगा ही दूसरे लोगों से जिनका विचार अलग है तो यहाँ विचार ये है फॉर यू नो फ्रॉम पीपल लाइक मार्क्स एंड अदर लिबरल थिंकर्स दैट हाउ कैन यू से दैट देर हैज बीन सच शॉर्टेज ऑफ फूड और पॉपुलेशन हैज नॉट बीन कंट्रोल्ड You know, or no economic growth. They believe, the critics believe, as you can see in the slide, that there have been a decline in the birth rate, epidemics have been controlled.
Ma'am, we are not able to hear you. Could you please unmute yourself? Hello ma'am. Okay, I think there's some connection error. We might move to another expert. I think we have faced some technical glitches and once again I want to tell you that in case of any doubts or queries if you have, feel free to contact us on our toll-free number that is 8800440559. As we were discussing about class 12th topic, so our email ID is dth.class12@ciet.nic.in. Now we were discussing about the topic that was demographic structure of Indian society. We were joined by a couple of experts, but I think due to some technical glitches, we are not able to hear them anymore. But we'll be back again within a couple of minutes. I have one more important announcement for you. Till we connect with our experts, you can do this one small thing. As we all know that commemorating 75 years of India's independence, the government of India has launched Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. And you can also be a part of this celebration and make this year even more memorable. How? Let me tell you how. This is a very simple thing that you have to do. You have to record national anthem or Jan Gan Man in your voice and your tone and send it to www.rashtragan.in. You'll also receive a certificate after that. Please do it now itself. You have time for today. Once again, I think we have joined with our experts. Abha ma'am, Seema ma'am.
Yes.
Yeah, our experts are once again with us and we'll be starting the session from here itself.
Sure.
Let me once again tell you that we were discussing about the demographic structure of Indian society and Abha ma'am was discussing about Malthusian theory and also the critics of Malthusian theory. Hello ma'am, am I audible? Is it okay
yes.
now?
Yes.
Yeah, you may proceed. You may proceed.
I now hand over to Seema ma'am for the next theory that she would be explaining.
Yes. Now the next theory is the demographic transition theory. Now this theory has been proposed by Thompson and you know it is that the three stages of the population growth from a underdeveloped technologically backward to a developed and technologically advanced. Now according to the sociologists and the demographers, now the every society, you know, goes through these three stages. And the demographic transition, it is a phenomena which refers to the historical shift, that is where there is a high birth, high death rate to an economically not developed to a developed society where reduced, the population has decreased and there is a low birth rate and low death. Now there are three stages. The first stage, that is the high birth rate and high death rate. Now this is the typical feature of a underdeveloped countries. Now here again the growth rate is low because both the birth rate and the death rate is high. Now growth rate is the difference between the birth rate and death rate. Now agar मतलब आबादी हो भी रही थी तो डेथ रेट भी बहुत हाई थी, क्योंकि जे व्हाई व्हाट वाज द रीजन, बेसिकली पीपल वेर नॉट अवेयर अबाउट द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ यू नो दे वेर अनएजुकेटेड, एडवांटेजेस ऑफ द स्मॉल फैमिली नॉर्म, मोर ओवर लैक ऑफ मेडिकल फैसिलिटीज, टेक्निकल एडवांसमेंट नहीं थी, तो काफी और नेचुरल कैलमिटीज एंड ऑल दीज थिंग्स. So, lot of people used to die in any the natural calamity which used to, you know, take place. That is the first stage. Now, the second stage where there is a high birth rate but low death. Now, before coming to the second stage, now the third stage I'll first take up. In the third stage, which is the characteristic of a developed countries where economically it has progressed and technological advancement has taken place. Now this is the third stage of the population. Here again the growth rate is low. Why? Because the birth rate has reduced. People have accepted the small family norm. Awareness logon mein aa gayi hai. Literacy rate increased in the level of education, literacy. All these, you know, it reduces or puts a pressure on when it comes to the reduction of the fertility rate and the low death rates. Low death rate because of the improvement in the medical science, technology with the developed countries. Now, in between the first stage and the third stage is the second stage. Now, second stage, what is it basically? That there is a high birth rate and low death rate leading to the population explosion. Now this is typically seen in the developing countries. Now in our country also, now in India we are also going through this demographic transition phase where the birth rate has reduced. The death rate has reduced because of the improvement in the medical science, nutrition, then other civic amenities which are there, but the correspondingly the birth rate has not reduced, because birth rate, it is a socio-cultural phenomenon which has. This is the reason which has led to the population explosion. The gap between the birth rate, the growth rate, when we are talking about, it is high in this particular stage, which is the second stage of the demographic transition theory. Again, I'll repeat it here that the death rate has reduced because of the improvement in the medical science, technology, and immunization, better facilities, control on the diseases, public health, whereas correspondingly the birth rate has not reduced because it is not easy to alter the reproductive behavior of the people. So that is why there is population explosion. Now this is regarding the two theories which is elaborated and explained in your textbook. One is the Malthusian theory and the second one is the theory of demographic transition. Now next now here it is, if you see the diagrammatic presentation, it is in the underdeveloped society, as I have told you, technologically backward, high birth rate and high death rate, the difference between the two is low. Now this is the low growth rate, this is the typically the characteristic, and as I have told you, the developed, it is the advanced countries. Now coming to the next topic for discussion, that is the terms and concepts of demography. These are the terms which are very important, and as a student of sociology, all of you should know it. Now, birth range, as you know, the number of live births in a given area during a given time period per 1,000 population. Now, birth rate, when we are talking about the sociologists, they are primarily, you know, interested in the birth rate, and because that affects the population growth and the size, and also the economic development, the prosperity is related to the birth rate. When we'll be discussing about, when Abha ma'am will be discussing about the demographic dividend, you will come to know more about, with the help of the pyramid, that how the diagrammatic presentation which is given in your textbook, that how the birth rate has reduced over the years and how India is going to benefit from the demographic dividend. Now, because we have one of the young countries as compared to other countries, we are the younger. So most of the population, younger population is there in our country. Then the next is the death rate. Number of deaths in a given area during a given time frame per 1,000 population. Now the fertility rate, number of live birth per 1,000 women in the childbearing age group. Now childbearing age group 15 to 49 years. Now if, now that is why one of the policies of, you will see that today's, you know, the delayed marriage. Now obviously the fertility period is reduced, that will also help to reduce the population. Then the infant mortality rate. Number of death of babies before the age of 1 year per 1,000 live births. Very unfortunate, in our country, many children, they are not able to celebrate their first birthday also. Malnutrition, you know, poverty, then lack of basic facilities, immunization, health and hygiene, and that is, all these factors are responsible for the mortality rate among the infants. Maternal mortality, this refers to number of women dying in the childbirth per 1,000 live birth. Now earlier, when you know science and technological advancement and the medical facilities was not there so much, so many women, they used to, you know, during the childbirth process, they were unable to survive. But nowadays, because of the improvement in the medical science and health sector also, so much of money has been, you know, spent by the government in the rural health sector also, development, the dispensary, the local health centers in the villages. So most of the deliveries are also taking place in the hospitals or the health centers, so which are able to deal with this, you know, maternal mortality rate. Now the sex ratio, it is the number of females per 1,000 males in a given area at a specified time period. Now I will be taking up the sex ratio later on in detail, that, you know, how there is a declining sex ratio and which is a concern for both the demographer and sociologist. The age structure of the population, the number of persons in the different age groups relative to the total population. And the another term that is the very important term, dependency ratio. The proportion of dependents. Now who are the dependents? Jo bachche hain, jo they are too small to work, and elderly population. जो बुजुर्ग है, तो अगर हम कहते हैं कि जो डिपेंडेंट पॉपुलेशन, अगर हमारे कंट्री में डिपेंडेंट पॉपुलेशन जो दैट इज द एल्डरली एंड द चिल्ड्रन, वो अगर हम कम हो जाते हैं, ऑब्वियसली इट इज द, इट एड्स टू द प्रॉस्पेरिटी. सो दैट इज द डिपेंडेंसी रेशियो, बिकॉज दे आर टू ओल्ड, पीपल हु आर टू ओल्ड टू वर्क, एंड चिल्ड्रन हु आर टू यंग टू वर्क. So these are the terms and the concepts related to demography, which is very important. And as a student of sociology, you should be aware about these terms. Now, another related to the terms and concepts when we are talking about the growth rate. Now, as I have told you when I was explaining the demographic transition theory, that is, the growth rate is the difference between the birth rate and the death rate. Now, when the difference is zero, almost or negligible or very small, we can say that the population has stabilized. Population has reached the replacement level. New generation to replace the older ones who are dying. Now, whereas there are some countries, you know, or the societies where there is a negative growth, the fertility level are below the replacement level, like Japan, Russia, Italy, and the Eastern Europe. Some societies experience very high growth rate, particularly when they are going through this demographic transition. Now, when we talk about the replacement level, for example, you know, husband wife, if we take one instance, they have two children. So two replaced by two. Husband wife, let's take another example, they have four children. So two is replaced, it is by four. And when the four of them, when they get married, and suppose the first, let's say A, B, C, D, A, you know, has three children, B, two, third one, like this. So how you can understand the population explosion that takes place? So India's, you know, TFR, the total fertility rate, is declining now, and it is 2.2 per woman. But TFR indicates, you know, the average, the number of children that is expected to be born to a woman during the reproductive, when we are talking about the span, that is 15 to 40 years. Now, another, as I've explained to you, the replacement level, which is a very important term, and states like Himachal Pradesh, Kerala, and they have no TFR as compared to Bihar, MP, Rajasthan. So high education, when we talk about awareness, then acceptance of the small family norms, all this, and overall prosperity also, which will be an important factor which can reduce the total fertility rate. So growth rate and the rate, that is the replacement level. Now, unlike the death rate, birth rate has not registered a sharp fall. Why? Birth rate is a socio-cultural phenomena. Especially in our country, you know, there are certain, some among the people who are not literate, or they're thinking that they keep on producing children, that the children are the gift of the God, or sometimes they don't want to accept the small family norm, lack of awareness, which is there. Even that is why education, if the moment they become literate and educated, they will understand the benefit of the small family, the quality of life, which is very important. So, but birth rate being a social and the cultural factors which are responsible. And many a times you must have been aware about in the families, they have large families, that that they should have a son, you know, who will take the aage vansh kaun chalayega. So all these thinking jab baat hum baat karte hain, ye bhi ek hamare jo social aur cultural factor hote hain, jo birth rate ko jo hamara increase ho rahe hain, ya jo over the years jo humne birth rate, you know, for last two decades mein jitne. Now it is, these are the factors which is responsible, and it takes time. So unlike the death rate, because death rate we have been able to, you know, reduce because of the improvement in the medical science, technology, then you know, public health sector, so much amount of money is spent, vaccination, immunization, all these things, the better nutrition, all the government, you know, so much money the government is spending on especially uplift the status of the people who are below the poverty line. All the facilities are given, and so that is why there is an improvement, and it is very good when we are talking about. So, but the correspondingly, we have not been able to reduce the birth rate. So the next I will ask Abha ma'am to explain about the age structure of the population, which is one of the concept, as I've told you, and she'll be elaborating it with the diagrams, which are very well given in your very exhaustive manner, which is given in your NCRT text.
Thank you, ma'am. I would like to now elaborate on the age structure of the population. Now, as you can see in the pyramid, there are different colors depicting the genders. And of course, do look here, aap dekh hi rahe hain pyramid ka with a broad base, and it goes up and gets tapered, narrow ho jata hai upar jate jate pyramid. This all is reflecting the proportion of persons in different age groups. And in the middle of that bar, that shows the age group. So the age structure of India's population has also undergone a drastic change. Matlab ke har age group mein the number of people has now changed. In the next few slides, you'll see that. But what is it that brings about a change in the age structure? Aisa kya transform ho jata hai? Ya kya cheez logon ko influence karti hai that they get impacted? And obviously, it would be the reproductive behavior. How many children, as ma'am has explained in great length, that people decide to have. And with that kind of a change in the reproductive behavior, there will be an automatic change in the age structure of the population. So basically, as the slide also says, the age structure changes in response to changes in level of development. Now here we focus on two aspects of development. One is literacy, and other is the improvement in the health provisions or health conditions. Dono conditions aisi hain. Literacy agar spread hoti hai to logo ke andar ek awareness aati hai. As they become aware of the small family norms and go by that, they automatically will have fewer children. This is very closely connected also to the kind of standard of living that they would want to have. They, people, as they become aware, they can see around them. Ke jo parivaron mein, jin parivaron mein kam bachche hain, wahan par unke paas kya resources available hote hain, unka standard of living kaisa hai, unke liye education, clothing, cleanliness, housing और बाकी की भी सारी facilities जो है वो अच्छे से share होती हैं. Those resources are equally shared by the children, especially if they are just about two children that they have. And on the other hand, a family with large number of children will have to undergo a lot of problems, financial, social, and so on, and infrastructural. So this, after seeing these kinds of comparisons, people generally become aware, and that is what is development is all about. The second thing is that they are provided good health facilities. With better health facilities, as ma'am has already explained, the death rate comes down. The life expectancy, the average life expectancy, I'm हमारे एल्डरली हैं उनके लिए अब बहुत सारी ऐसी फैसिलिटीज हैं जिससे कि दे लिव लॉन्गर एंड इवन ऑन एन एवरेज जो एवरेज लाइफ एक्सपेक्टेंसी है दैट हैज इंक्रीज. सो इफ वी सी फ्यूअर बर्थ रेट्स इफ वी एनालाइज ओके द नेक्स्ट इज दैट दे लिव लॉन्गर द थर्ड इज बेटर हेल्थ कंडीशंस. What is happening is that in every area of this age group, in every age group, the proportion of persons will start changing. Ab aap pichla pyramid dekhiye, look at the and remember the figure and look at this pyramid. There is a huge difference. So this is the predicted population pyramid, which is for 2026, which again is trying to analyze the change. If you can understand what are the changes that you see here, or what you observe basically, is that the base has become quite narrow. Again, it is reflecting a low birth. What is this showing? The change in the reproductive behavior. Log pehle jo dowry या मेल चाइल्ड प्रेफरेंस के लिए दे यूज टू कीप हैविंग चिल्ड्रन नाउ दे आर यू नो नाउ दे डोंट गो बाय दैट. एज आई सेड देर इज मोर अट्रैक्शन टुवर्ड्स अ बेटर लाइफस्टाइल गिविंग देयर चिल्ड्रन गुड एजुकेशन मेकिंग देम बेटर सिटीजन्स मोर प्रोडक्टिव ह्यूमन रिसोर्स. तो ये सारी चीजों को ध्यान में रखते हुए ऑटोमेटिकली देर हैज बीन दिस देर विल बी most probably it's the positive picture we see here that this is the kind of change that we expect by 2020.
Yeah, ma'am. As we were discussing about the demographic dividend of the country, we know that India is the only country in the world with the maximum number of youth faces. So yes. Here one question arises that how this kind of demographic dividend could be used as a resource for the country instead of a liability.
Well, there are two important things. One is that this human resource has to be educated. It has to be literate. And along with literacy, it's not just literacy, there has to be skill training. And the skill training that people acquire, the youth acquires, would get them employment or jobs. So even though there may be, you know, literate people around, if they are not employed, they continue to be a liability. That is what is happening, you know, currently also, that we have children who are employed, who are educated, who are literate, but somewhere they are not skilled enough to be employed. So that again is not a very happy situation for us. So therefore this middle bulge requires, this is what the textbook also says, that this liability of the, we won't say the youth population, but generally, because we have the resource of the youth, it is very essential for us to convert it into an asset. And that can be done by utilizing the middle bulge in the most productive manner. And here,
very well explained, ma'am. Thank you for that. You may proceed with the topic.
Yes. And as children can see, and you all can see on the slide here, this middle bulge is going to be the road to development, growth and progress for our country. And of course, the government has a whole lot of schemes for also initiating this kind of skill development. The age group here, what is demographic dividend, is basically the age group, the population between the age group of 15 to 64 years, which is also our demographic advantage. That means an asset. Now, when we talk of the age structure, like we have discussed, in every particular age group, there will be a change, there will be a transition, an increase or a decrease. So here, there are a few concepts that children must understand. That there will be a fall in the dependency ratio, definitely, if the birth rate goes down. And that means the number of dependents, as ma'am has explained, they will come down. And when the number of dependents come down, but then there is another thing that's happening. The number ऑफ द ग्रे पॉपुलेशन द एल्डरली आर इंक्रीज, तो उनके लिए क्या करना चाहिए? उनके लिए फिर पॉलिसीज ऐसी होनी चाहिए विच वुड हेल्प टू सपोर्ट द एल्डरली ऑफ द सोसाइटी. So as the age structure is changing, as the numbers in every age group are changing, so does the change in the population policies or in the policies which would be in favor of these particular groups. On the other hand, these are the two things that they have to deal in the textbook. The rising dependency ratio in any situation when there was, and there will be in any, you know, in other countries as well, wherever there is a rising dependency ratio, what happens is that the number of dependents increases, and there is a small section of the population which is working and supporting. So obviously then that becomes a burden and it leads to a decline in the economic growth. On the other hand, the falling dependency ratio is the cause or source of economic growth and prosperity. Now, the change that we can analyze in the case of India, the base has become less broad, which shows a lowering of the birth rate. The middle bulge that we have seen in the previous slide is telling us about an increase in the demographic dividend. Then dependency ratio has decreased considerably because the number of children born are much fewer as well as. And then the broader top, which is again, I'm going back to the slide to show you, the broader top shows that there is an increase in the gray population or the elders in the society. So this aging population has increased. So this is about, and then one more chart, which is from the text as well, and it is describing what would be. See, the states have also undergone change and will be undergoing change, and we know very well why these certain states, because of the pressure of the population, because of the literacy rates, there would be a faster change in some states and a slightly slower one in others. But all are coping with this trend of change in the age structure. And as we can see, the middle bulge is appearing to be bigger and bigger in due course of time, because it's all about 2026. I hope the concept is clear for children.
Yeah, ma'am. Yeah. Absolutely.
Seema ma'am would like to cover up this section now.
Yeah, sure. Abha ma'am, thank you. Now, literacy and demography. When we talk about how literacy is important, because the moment they become literate, they are educated. The population, which is also, and they become empowered. Now, empowerment, obviously, they become aware of their rights. They are, they can participate in public spheres, and they can take the decision. So it enhances career options, knowledge economy, participation in the cultural and economic well-being of the community. Now there's their skill, they can enhance their skill for the livelihood, and obviously health awareness, what Abha ma'am has already highlighted, that hygiene, sanitation, immunization, all these contribute to the well-being of the population. Now there is an literacy, when we see it varies across, gender, there is a regional variation and the disadvantaged communities. Now the literacy rate at present it is, the latest census 74%, more than 74% the literacy rate, but the male-female literacy rate, there is a gap, there is a difference. So when we talk about, it varies across the gender. So the female literacy rate is less as compared to the male literacy. Similarly, when the regional variation is there, Kerala has reached, highest literacy with 93% or more than that. Then even Lakshadweep, Mizoram, whereas states like Bihar, you know, they are lagging behind. So there is a variation when we talk about the literacy rate. So in our country, we have states like Kerala also, and we have states like Bihar and other UP. When it comes to the disadvantaged group, again, it has been seen that the literacy rate, there is a difference where it comes to the people who are the scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, because they were denied access to the education earlier. So they are as compared to the other population, there is a variation. That is why the government has introduced the reservation policies to bring them at par with the others. Now, this is regarding how, literacy is very important, because how it can lead to the empowerment and once the strengthening their participation. Now, another the concept when we are talking about the next that I'm going to discuss is the sex ratio. Now, sex ratio, I have already, when we were discussing about the terms and concept, it refers to the number of males per thousand, males in a given area. Now, the female girl babies, they appear to be having an advantage over the male babies as far as the survival is concerned. But if you see, it's a concern for the demographers and the sociologists, that is, there is a declining sex ratio over the years, and there is a slight improvement in 2011 census. If you see that it is, earlier it was 9, and how it has 927, and how it has now improved. Now, what are the reasons for the decline in the child sex ratio? The severe neglect of the girl, the differential treatment, sex-specific abortion, which is totally illegal, misuse of the technology, that is called female feticide, and even female infanticide. One is female feticide, that the female fetus is aborted the moment they come to know. Now, this test was basically, introduced in the medical, when we are talking about, to if there is any abnormality with the growing fetus, and that to identify. But how people have misused it, and that is why, the government has banned and punishes those if there is a prenatal sex screening, and they come to know, because then they go for the abortion. So misuse, then the female infanticide, because of the cultural and the religious belief, which you are aware about it in our country, how the infant girl, they are neglected, maybe the differential treatment which is given to the boy baby, and at the infancy stage they are more prone to infection. And if the immunization and other is not taken care of. Another, what are the reasons? Because of the poverty, we can say, rigid patriarchal system, and the dowry, that girls then, dowry has to be given at the time of the marriage, the rigid patriarchal system where it is a male dominated, preference for a male child in our society. So all these are the factors which are responsible for the declining sex ratio in our country. And another aspect,
yeah, ma'am,
which
very rightly explained by you regarding the sex ratio. Obviously, we wish to continue this session, but we are short of time. I would like to thank my experts, Mrs. Abha ma'am and Mrs. Seema ji. Thank you so much for being here and throwing light on the concepts like demography, the types of demography, importance of demographic data. Obviously, we are left by two topics, that were rural and urban difference and population policy. Could we take them in the next session?
Sure.
Yeah. Sure, so, do we have any questions, any homework for our viewers? Just a few questions, a few input for, like from the point of view of examinations.
Well, you know, I would like to add one thing, because when we are talking about the sex ratio and the declining, some of the initiative which have been taken by the government, you know, and let them find it about, like one I'm telling you, the Beti Bachao, Beti Parao, and other initiative, let them find it out, let them do the, you know, search through the internet, and the government program to deal with there, because there is a regional variation also in the declining sex ratio. And
Of course, I'm sure that our viewers will be finding those initiatives, the digital initiatives that have been started by our government to increase the population of girls, obviously, and to strengthen our demographic dividend in the country. Once again, I would like to thank my experts. Thank you both of you for being with us and for this lively interaction. I would also like to thank all our viewers for your active participation. Let me inform you once again that in case you miss this session, you don't have to worry about it, or you have missed our previous sessions, you can always go to our YouTube channel. That is NCERT Official. Also, in case of doubts or queries or anything related, or you want to convey to us anything, please dial our toll-free number, that is 8800440559. As we were discussing about class 12th, our official mail ID for class 12th is dth.class12@ciet.nic.in. We are wrapping up this session of sociology, but I have one important announcement for you. As you know that we are observing 75 years of the nation's independence. So the Government of India, to make this year more memorable, has launched Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. You can also be a part of this worthy celebration by doing just this simple thing. What you have to do is record in your voice Jan Gan Man, or the national anthem of the country, and send it to www.rashtragan.in. We are wrapping up our session, but stay connected with us, because at 5:30 p.m. we'll be doing another session for Nishtha Initiative, and our topic of discussion is ICT in teaching, learning and assessment. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you.